In this Photoshop video, we'll be making a custom clipping path and use that to create this clipping path portrait. Pretty straightforward, but there are a couple little tricks in here you probably haven't seen in the past. Don't forget to subscribe and, of course, like and share as well. And if you want to learn a lot more about the Photoshop program, take a look at my complete training course and you'll find a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Let's close this project down and start off with a brand new file. File new, and I'll leave it at the default Photoshop element size. There we go, right there. And choose create. And there it is. Let's put this to fit screen. The first thing we need is just a big circle in here. So let's just grab the circle shape over here, left-hand side, right there. It's the elliptical tool, right there, ellipse tool. And set the options to circle and from center, right in there. And up here you want fill at black and stroke. Let's set the stroke to nothing, just to zero on the stroke. And then come into the middle of the page someplace and pull out. Now notice you can see the size of this circle in that little pop-up right down by the cursor. Pull it out so it's just about at 1,000, close to 1,000. And then we can reset that up here to exactly 1,000. And I'll set this side as well. There we go. Okay, looks good. Go over here to the Move tool and move around just a little bit and it should pop right into center. You see there's the center guidelines. There it is. It's now exactly at the center of the page. Okay, we'll close that down. So first part done. Now, we'll use this as the basis for creating those interesting squiggly lines. Go up to Filter and come down to Distort and then down to the Wave filter right here. This is an unusual filter in that it distorts your image in a wavy pattern. Now we can't do this directly on a shape, so we have to convert this. I'll click on Rasterize, which is what you want, and there is the Wave filter. It does interesting stuff, but kind of randomizes this. You get some interesting, strange things happening. Now the numbers you want here, on number of generators, set this at 32. On wavelength, you want this at 93 and 94. There we go. Just to the right of that, you get the type over here. Set the type to square. Notice how this takes that circle and then breaks it up into four pieces. So now I have four circles on the page. So generators 32, wavelength 93, 94. On amplitude here, set the minimum to 1 and set the maximum to 14. Down below that we have the scale at 100 and 100, and that's fine. And then repeat edges. At this point you can randomize this. Just kind of click around. And what you want is to have something with a reasonably good sized piece in the middle here and just some straight lines. I'm just going to go through just a few times. That's not too bad right there. That's, you know, a little more lines. I don't want it quite that small. So just click on randomize a few times until you get kind of a nice size in here. Once you have that, just click on OK. And it then applies that effect. Interesting already, but we don't have the waviness in here. To do that, we're going to be reapplying that wave filter a second time. So filter, come back down to distort, and wave. Now let's change our settings. Change the type over here to a sine. You can already see there's some waviness in there. Number of generators, bring this number of generators down to 5. On the wavelength, bring your wavelength down to 70 and 71. And there we go, there's our nice little kind of wavy lines. Again, I'm going to randomize this, and what I'm looking for is nice, solid straight lines. That one was pretty good. That has some nice waves, and they're pretty solid. Okay, those waves are even more, so I like that. That looks like a real nice one. Choose OK. And here's this kind of interesting wavy thing happening in here. Now, this will be random, so yours will not look exactly like mine. There will be differences on this. Now we have all these little pieces out here. We need to get rid of all of that stuff. We can easily do that just by using the eraser. Grab the eraser tool over here and just come in and then take the time to go through and erase all these little things. If you get this kind of a strange thing in here, just take it out like that and go through and erase all this stuff out. Now I'm going to pause the video at this point. I'll finish this erasing step, and once this is done, then I'll bring the video back up again. Okay, here we go. Now it's not ready yet. There are a few things. I'm just going to zoom in a little bit up here. You see some of these have these little chop outs like that, and this piece is missing down here. And then we have some of these crossover pieces down in there. Now you can leave the crossovers if you want. That's up to you. Sometimes those are nice, sometimes they're not. It depends. I think I'll take this one out right here. And this little bit here and this little bit over here, those can go away. We can get rid of some of these as well, possibly, but I think I'll leave them mostly in. Two ways to approach this. One is to come in and fill in these inner areas with black. That gives you more of a space in here for your portrait, or to come out and erase them from the outside. It's up to you. But I'll fix a couple of these things. Let's zoom in a little bit here. We'll do this section first. Now this can be fixed with just a black paintbrush. I have mine set at 20 pixels right now, and it's a hard paintbrush. And just come in, just do a little bit like that. Just kind of paint that in. There you go. If it's a little bit off on the edges, you can always go back with the eraser tool and then just clean that up. Okay, let's go around. I'll do one more of these. There's one right down here. Let's just put this just like that. So just kind of fill those in where you see those little cutouts happening. And that cleans up that. Okay, back to the zoom tool here. So I'll go through and I'll fix those little bits off camera. But let's fix this little bit right here to show you how I take care of these things like that. Same basic idea, just grab the eraser tool and make my brush a little bit smaller here. That's just using the left square bracket on that. And I'll just come in and tap that a couple of times and erase that out. And that little bit right there and this little bit right in there. So I'll go through and I'll clean some of those things out. And then back to the zoom tool here. And let's take a quick look at this bit right here. So if you want to get rid of something like that, just grab your paintbrush and paint that out. Of course, make sure you're working with black color. There you go. So easy to do. I'll now go through and do all of that cleanup in here and clean up a few of those little bits and make sure there aren't any of these little cutouts showing. You don't have to be perfect on this. Just, you know, get rid of the worst of the pieces and then you're okay. All right, I'll go ahead now and I'll pause the video and do that cleanup stage with the paintbrush and with the eraser. Once that's done, I'll bring up the video back up again. And there we go. There's our kind of a squiggly sunburst effect all ready to go. We now need to bring our picture in. And I'll just do a place on this one, file, and come down to place embedded so that it's inside of the project and not kind of linked outside. I want it just inside of the project. And there's my picture right there. Choose OK. And there it is, comes in placed. Go ahead and click the check mark, put that in position. Now, I have a link for this picture. There's a link for all this stuff down in the description. There's also a link for the finished Photoshop file as well. If you want to download those, you can get those right from the description. Okay, I'm going to set this picture here at about 50%. We can now position it so that her face is nicely inside of that open area right there. And that looks pretty good. Right about there is fine. And then I'll bring it back up to 100%. Right click on the name of that layer and create clipping mask. That puts her inside of that shape right there. Now notice up here that the picture wasn't big enough. We're missing a little bit up there. It's easy to fix. Now as I brought this in embedded, it came in as a smart object. So just right click on the name and we're going to rasterize the layer right there. We now can take the rectangular marquee tool up here, I'll just drag a marquee like that right around that section. And then using the Control T keyboard shortcut will bring up control handles on that. I can now grab that with my move tool and pull that straight up. It's like you can stretch that picture, and it stretches it from here up. It doesn't touch anything below that. It only stretches what's inside of that selection, and that's all we need there to fix that bit. Okay, go ahead and deselect that. There it is. There's the basic picture. Let's now add some layer styling onto this basic shape. Back to our shape layer. There it is. And layer, come down to layer style. We'll be doing a bevel and emboss. You can see it there, right there. Now what this is, it's an inner bevel. There you go. Technique is smooth. The depth is pretty big. It's 573%. Pretty large. Direction is up. Size is 10 pixels. And then the soften down here is just 0. Everything else is left at the default settings. And that gives us a nice little edge on this, giving this a thickness. Let's now bring the effects back up. Just double click on those. Let's add a drop shadow in on this one. Come down to your drop shadow layer. I'm going to change the angle here to 130 so that it's, the light's coming up for the upper left-hand corner, kind of coming down that direction. And everything else looks good. The distance, I have it at 12 pixels, and the size is at 10 pixels. The size is how soft that edge of that shadow is. So I have mine at 10 pixels and choose OK. There's our nice little 3D effect on this, almost as if this was made out of a metal piece that had our picture printed on top of that metal piece. Okay, let's now put a background on this. Let's come down to the background layer and then go up to layer and new fill layer and gradient. Choose OK. It gives you just a basic gradient like that. Lots of options in here to choose from. The one I'm using, if we go up here, and that is pastels right there. And it's the last one here. Wait for that pop up. There it is. Brown, tan, and beige. Just a real basic one. The colors match the picture nicely on that, and choose OK. OK, I think she's a little bit too small on the page. So let's grab her picture, hold the shift key down, and grab the shape layer. So those two layers are selected. Control T keyboard shortcut. Just grab a corner, hold the shift key down. This it enlarge her and put her back towards center again. And that looks better right there. Just made her a bit bigger on the page, and choose OK. Last little bit, let's do a little bit of adjustment here to the portrait layer. So come back up to the portrait layer, and we'll do a layer adjustment on that. So layer, come down to new adjustment layer levels. Where it says use previous layer to create clipping mask, make sure that is selected and choose OK. That will then only apply this onto her image and nothing else. So in here, let's just go ahead and richen up the darks. That's the problem there, is that her darks really aren't dark enough. Looks like up here, someplace in the low 50s is pretty good on that. So you can just brings in some richness into her photograph. The middle one controls the overall mid-tone values. It looks like the one, which is the default, is pretty good on that. The high end are your lights. I don't care about those in this one. So it's really just the dark side here. You know, low to mid 50s. And it gives us some nice contrast in there. And there we go. Got an interesting little effect, little portrait effect. And it's all done by doing a custom shape in here using that wave filter a couple of times. It's kind of interesting. Random wavy effect. Now, if you enjoyed this project, make sure you hit that like button and the share button as well. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so, and look at my complete training course, and you'll find a link for that right down there in the description.